The terror group that aspired to be an empire is now making its final stand in Syria. Along the Euphrates River in the east, the remnants of ISIS, once a formidable force, is besieged by Kurdish and Arab forces on the ground and US-led coalition warplanes from the air. Freelance cameraman Gabriel Chaim filmed this exclusive and dramatic footage you'll see only on CNN. And we want to warn you first, some of it is graphic. Our Ben Wedeman has the story.
They're planning their next move in the final showdown with the last remnants of ISIS. Commander Havel Simko of the Syrian Democratic Forces is leading his men on a night operation. Their progress lit by flares into the last stronghold of what was the so-called Islamic State. Now reduced to a remote and ever-shrinking sliver of land along the Euphrates River in eastern Syria. At first light, coalition aircraft begin to bomb. As troops venture into the town of Susa, or what's left of it. With the help of artillery and airplanes, we were able to take control of this place, the soldier tells cameraman Gabriel Chaim, who shot this exclusive video for CNN. The soldier vows, within 10 days, God willing, we will finish. It may take longer than that. ISIS isn't giving ground easily. They counterattacked. Heavy machine gun fire didn't stop them. The troops had to retreat. By day's end, reinforcements arrived and they were back on the offensive. Not, however, without cost. The next day starts with a mortar bombardment. The adjacent town of Marajda, the objective. On the edge of town, a soldier carries a baby. The family follows. But the soldiers are wary. These last villages are full of ISIS's most hardcore supporters. Everyone is treated with suspicion. They order the young men to take off their shirts to show they're not concealing weapons or explosives. This family's next destination, one of many camps out in the desert, filling up with tens of thousands who have fled the fighting. Civilians want to escape to safety, says this soldier, but ISIS threatens them with their weapons to go back so the coalition airplanes won't hit them. Those who defied ISIS paid the ultimate price. Under these blankets, the soldiers say, are 8 children and 2 women killed while trying to escape. The images, too gruesome to show. The ISIS fighters did escape, leaving behind weapons and ammunition. Yet the battle rages on. ISIS's last stand, its last battle, its last bastion, will go down in a torrent of fire and blood.
Let's get over now to CNN's Ben Wedeman, who brought us that report. Ben, we can see there in that very powerful footage there from Gabriel Chaim that, you know, as you said as well, ISIS is not giving ground easily. But if this is the last stand, then when it's over, will Donald Trump, the U.S. president, be right in saying that ISIS is now defeated?
To qualify this, ISIS as the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria, as an entity that really came into being in late 2013, or most importantly, 2014 in June with the conquest of Mosul, will no longer exist as what essentially amounted to a state with a bureaucracy, with taxes and that sort of thing. However, ISIS as an idea, as the Islamic Caliphate that was the brainchild of Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, is far from defeated, far from dead. Keep in mind, they control, or affiliates of ISIS control territory in the Egypt Sinai Peninsula, in Libya, other parts of Africa, as far away as the Philippines and Afghanistan. So yes, this chapter of the history of the Islamic State may be about to end, but ISIS is not over yet.
And Ben, I mean, what about the, we know from Donald Trump that he wants to pull US troops out of Syria. I'm wondering what impact that has already had on the battlefield, on both sides of the battlefield, whether people are buoyed by that news or whether morale is really low as a result of it.
And on the one hand, what we have seen is a real intensification of U.S.-led coalition bombardments of ISIS targets in this area of eastern Syria. We know, for instance, that there are U.S. special forces in the area doing, among other things, looking for anybody who might be a leader of ISIS. And, of course, they are looking for Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. So there's a real intensive U.S. and other coalition forces involvement on the ground in this battle. But when you step back and you look at the big picture, the future of this part of Syria, there are a lot of questions, there's a lot of doubt, there is a lot of worry. We know that Kurdish leaders in this part of Syria are in discussions with Damascus because their main concern is not necessarily continuing to fight ISIS. Their concern is that Turkey will enter that part of Syria and essentially crush those forces there. So on the battlefield, it does appear that the Kurdish and Arab fighters who are in this battle against ISIS are receiving significant support and backing from the United States and its allies. But the big picture, on the political picture, there is a lot of worry about what the future holds.